I expect quite a few of you have got a bit of free time in your hands, and you may be considering going through your images and entering a few of them into a photography competition, particularly with the closing date of Landscape Photographer of the Year coming up. So in this video, I'm going to share with you my top tips for entering photography competitions. Number one, read the rules of the competition. I can't stress how important this is. It's absolutely critical that you understand what the rules and the regulations are of the competition. Understand what your rights are, or more importantly, what rights you'll be granting to the people that run the competition. You will need to grant some rights to your images to the people that run the competition so that they can display your work or your images should you be a category winner or win any sort of prize. Only you can decide whether you're comfortable with the amount of rights that you'll be granting to the people that run the competition. So read that carefully. Also, read the rules very carefully as well. Understand, you know, how much image manipulation, if any, is actually allowed. And don't listen to Twitter, don't listen to people saying, oh, you can't do this and you can't do that. Read the rules for yourself. There's interesting ones like you get in Scottish Landscape Photographer of the Year. If you've captured an image while under tuition, so whether that's a one-to-one or a workshop, for example, you're not eligible to win one of the categories or win the overall prize, but you can still submit the picture and you can still get a commended award. So it's those little nuances. It's really important to read those rules so you can understand what's allowed and what's not allowed. Tip number two, get organized. It's really important that you organize your images. So no matter which tool you use, I use Lightroom, get your images organized. Use keywording, location data, star rating. However you want to do it, get your images organized because you will find the process of selecting your images for a particular competition a lot easier if everything's organized. If it's not organized, you're going to struggle to find those pictures. You might even miss a really important picture that could be a possible winner that you completely forgot about, and you get all stressed and you're trying to find all these different pictures. So get yourself organized. Like I said, I use Lightroom. So as an example, when I go to pick out my pictures for Scottish Landscape Photographer of the Year, I create a dynamic collection. I look for all images that are tagged landscape, have the keyword Scotland in them, and they're all over 3 stars, and I get a nice quick view of all my images that I might possibly want to downselect for submission into Scottish Landscape Photographer of the Year. If you want to know how I organize my Lightroom catalog, I'll include a link for that video in the corner of the screen. Number three, select your images and take your time. Really important this. Don't wait to the day before the competition closes where you go and select 15 quick images and you just dump them into the competition. Put a bit more thought into it. At least a few weeks before the competition ends, what I tend to do is I create my first pass collection. So I create a collection in Lightroom and I'll look at the dynamic collection that I created in the previous tip and I'll drag the most likely candidates into that folder for consideration later on. And then I'll wait a few days so I've got another fresh pair of eyes on it, and then I'll go through and that's where I start the hard process of downselecting which images I'm going to enter. And it's also at this point I start to consider the categories. Many photography competitions have different categories, and even some of the categories have different rules. You might find a category that supports digital manipulation and one that doesn't. So you've got to carefully think about what the theme is and what the rules are of that category. And you've got to select the images for the right category. There's no point in putting a landscape image into a cityscape category. I know that's a bit of a dramatic example, but you know, think about it carefully because your images will be judged based on the category that they're in. And also, if you've got some images that maybe you've even submitted in previous years, even to the same competition, but haven't got anywhere, but you still think it stands a good chance, do enter them. I've entered images into photography competitions where even in the same competition, previous years it's got nowhere at all, and then all of a sudden one year you get a commended award. So make sure you pick out the images that you're most happy with and that I think will do well. Number four, submit your images. Now this is another one not to leave to the last minute. Get your images in nice and early and read what the submission guidelines are. Do your pictures need to be in a particular file format? Do they need to be in JPEG or TIFF? Is there a maximum file size? Do the pictures have to be a certain resolution, or only a certain resolution across one side? Do they need to be in a particular color space? Do they need to have a particular file name and format? Do you need to include captions, for example? I mean, captions can be really difficult to write So if you've left that to the last minute and you've got 15 captions to write, you're going to be under a bit of pressure. So make sure that you understand when those images have got to be submitted and how they've got to be submitted, but do not leave it to the last minute. Number five, know the key dates of your competition. Now, the one you will obviously know is the closing date for submissions, but do you know when the first round of judging is complete or when the shortlist gets announced? It's really important to know these dates. Now, some competitions will publish those, so you've got a clear understanding. Others you will be able to extrapolate because you've maybe entered the competition in previous years. But sometimes if you're a bit clever and you do a bit of Google searching, you can sometimes find out when those announcements get made based on people's social media posts. But the reason you want to know these dates is that quite often, for example, when you get shortlisted, that's the point in which you submit your raw file or your high resolution version of the image. So it's important that you have access to those files when you need it to be. So quite often I've been away on holiday when these competition shortlists get announced. So I always like make sure I've got some way of taking those files with me on holiday so I can still submit them for the next round of judging in the competition. The other important thing to do is to, if they publish it, take a note of the email address that these notifications are going to come from, because quite often these types of messages get bunged in junk mail folders and by your email system. So make a note of that, add it to your safe senders list, or at the very least, check your junk folder on a regular basis and check there's not a message there, because the last thing you want to do is find out when it's too late that there was an image there that got shortlisted and you didn't see the message. So they're my tips for entering photography competitions. But no matter what happens, whether you win the grand prize or you get a commended award or you don't get placed at all, be gracious. If you did win a prize or you got a commended award, by all means, take to social media and shout about it, because quite often getting placed in a competition is definitely something to be proud of. But if you didn't get placed or you didn't get the prize that you're looking for, or perhaps you didn't like the winning image, don't then take to social media to complain about it. Oh, I don't understand what the judges were looking for. This is a terrible competition. This is a terrible winning image. Be happy for the people that did get placed and be happy for the overall winner itself. Be gracious. At the end of the day though, what do I know? Photography competitions are fickle things. You never quite know what's going to catch the judge's eye. Like I said previously, I've submitted images into the same competition year after year, and it might be the third year before it finally gets a commended award. So the judges change, what they're looking for changes, and sometimes you just need a little bit of luck. For example, this image here that I'm popping up on the screen, this I submitted into Scottish Landscape Photographer of the Year last year, and it's only a, well, only what I classify as a 4-star image, so it's not even one of my favourite best images, it's not like a 5-star image, but it got a commended award in the competition. So, you know, sometimes it's really hard to tell, but hopefully these tips will allow you to focus on some of the process things that you can do to really increase your chances by getting the submission and the selection right. But don't just take my word for it. I've been speaking to Andi Campbell, and he is the current Wex Photographer of the Year. This is not an easy prize to win. You've got to consistently submit great images for the duration of a year. Not an easy title to win at all. So if anyone's got some good tips, it's Andi, and he's shared three of them. First one is, make sure your images are technically sound. Two, make sure you understand the rules of photography before you decide to break them. And three, use online communities. There are a whole range of online communities out there that can help support your desire to win competitions. There are people that will give you proper constructive critique and help you shape your entries for competitions. So thanks very much, Andi, for sharing those tips with me. And if you haven't seen Andy's work, I really suggest you go and have a look at it. I'll include a link for that in the video description below. Well, that's just about it for me. Now, have you got any tips for submitting photographs into photography competitions? Are you entering a photography competition? Are you entering Landscape Photographer of the Year? Or have you won a prize previously? Please do let me know in the comments below. Now, if you have liked this video, please do hit that like button, leave me a comment, share it, subscribe, all that good stuff. But until the next one, I'll see you then.